He made the table when I'm in need. Yeah, he's a master chemist indeed. Oh, he's a chem digger. Bring chem to all that brings chem to me. Now I ain't saying he's a chem digger, but he made the chem scene bigger. Now I ain't saying he's a chem digger, but he made the chem scene bigger. Get down, Mads, go ahead, get down. Get down, Mads, go ahead, get down. Get down, Mads, go ahead, get down. Get down, Mads, go ahead.
Hydrogen at the bomb, met her at the first column with the sexy oxygen. At this room temperature, the compound flowed like a liquid. It must have been water, man, the way that they kicked it. I can tell by the bond and the way that they formed it. Highly electronegative, it nearly shocked it. The electricity produced, but it was polar like a universal solvent. But put the compound in the freezer for too long, have you seen it? The temperature told me it was cold like Serena. Hydrogen, covalent bonds, ions, and only some of these bonds will share electrons. Okay, get the ionic compound. Compound that electrons it won't share. Instead gives and takes, but if you dare, bring along a covalent bond like carbon dioxide. Oh wait, carbon oxygen, what's the relationship that's responding? Both are non-metallic elements? Does that just happen to coincide? No, it's actually very common. Two non-metals form and cause covalent bonding. Now take an ionic compound like NaCl, there is a relationship there. Now just follow the rule, it's almost always right. Yeah, and that's totally fair.
Made the chem scene bigger. Get down, Mads, go ahead, get down. Get down, Mads, go ahead, get down. Get down, Mads, go ahead, get down. Get down, Mads, go ahead.